Hi, and welcome to Design for Life Bible Study, Week 3. This week we're taking a look at our spiritual gifting and how God gives us certain gifts to help us as we serve Him on this earth. And we're going to look today at the life of Agabus. Now, Agabus was a prophet, and so we read about his life in the book of Acts, Acts 11 and 21, where Agabus actually does some things that are phenomenal. He tells the future. He does it in two different ways that we see in the book of Acts. First off, he tells about a famine that hasn't come yet, but yet is coming. And in doing so, he saves the lives of people who would otherwise starve. Phenomenal to be able to know that a famine is coming, to declare it verbally, for people to change what they do and actually avoid calamity. That's the gift that God gave to Agabus through prophecy. Now, he not only saved lives, but we also see that when the Apostle Paul is about to go back to Jerusalem, Agabus shows up again, and this time he takes his belt off and he ties it around Paul's arms so that it's like he's a captive. And he declares once again what is about to happen, that Paul's going to go to Jerusalem and he's going to be taken captive. And he urges Paul not to go. You see, he didn't know how God was going to use that situation. He just knew it was going to happen. And Paul says, no, I'm willing to go. In fact, I'm happy to go. And Paul does go. And in fact, he does get taken as a prisoner by the Romans. But God uses that for his purposes. But what we see here is the life of a prophet. Now, prophecy is just one of many spiritual gifts that God gives. And in the Bible, we can read a list of all these spiritual gifts that God gives to his people. A prophet is anybody who speaks the words of God to the people of God. It's not always telling the future. Sometimes it's just declaring what God wants people to focus on. In fact, all of the writers of the Bible could be considered prophets because they're people who God spoke to and inspired them to speak the words of God to the people of God through the written word. Today, this gift is still given to the body. Certain people have the gift of the prophetic, of being able to speak the word of God to the people of God. But again, there's a lot of different gifts that God gives to his people. What gift has God given to you? Part of this series is we want you to be able to discover your spiritual gifts. And so as you begin to uncover and discover what God has given to you, we believe that God's going to not only tell you what your spiritual gift is, but help you understand how to use it. Now, why does God give spiritual gifts? Always, he gives us spiritual gifts to strengthen the body. There's natural gifts. You might be naturally gifted at something. All people have certain natural gifts. But supernatural gifts are given for the purpose specifically of strengthening the people of God to do the work of God. Now, God's power is available to God's people, and that should encourage you. Because sometimes we feel overwhelmed with life, like, what could I actually do? And we understand that men like Agabus, who had a gift of prophecy, he didn't have to somehow find the strength to do it, to figure it out, to be smart. He was given this gift by God, and it was easy for him because it was his gift. And you'll find the same is true for you when you're operating in your areas of spiritual giftedness. And we all have different gifts, and we all have different amounts of gifts. Some people have two or three. Some people might have five or six. But when you operate in those places of gifting, it will seem easy to you because it was a gift from God. And gifts are not hard. They're easy. And then lastly, you don't need to be enough because God is enough. And I just want to tell you, take the pressure off of you. Once you find out your spiritual gift, you don't have to somehow become great. Just be willing and let God use your gifts. He will work through you, through those gifts, to strengthen the body. Let's just be faithful. And again, let's enjoy the ride.